Hey, today I'm going to show you how to reverse clips in DaVinci Resolve 16. There's a very simple way to do it, and there's a little bit more difficult way, but it's going to add a lot more features, and I'm going to show you both ways, so stay tuned. Okay, so I have a couple of clips here, and they're kind of jumping clips. So we have jump rope, we have somebody jumping into the water from a platform, and a swimmer diving from the blocks right into the pool. So let's go ahead. I want to take this center clip and I want to do some reverse on that one. And so I'm going to show you the simple way first. Go ahead and select it, right click on the clip, and we're going to go ahead and go to change clip speed. And there's an option here. I'm going to turn off this ripple sequence for now. There's an option here though to reverse the speed. Let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to change this to maintain timing even though it's 100%. Go ahead and change that. And this center clip is a slow motion video, but you can see right away that that is reversed. So that's the simple way to do it. Go ahead and undo that. And so I'm going to right click again, and I'm going to change the clip speed, show you a little bit different way to do this. And so say I want to speed that up a bit, go ahead and select this ripple sequence and select the reverse speed. Let's go ahead and bump that all the way up to negative 400. Go ahead and hit change. And so what I did first is I did maintain timing. And so let's watch that. So that's pretty good. Let's undo that. This time you can see I had that auto select off. Let's go ahead and select auto select. I'm gonna right click on it, change clip speed, keep this ripple sequence on, reverse clip speed. I'm going to go to negative 400 again. Go back to maintain timing and change. And now because we have auto select selected, it's going to go ahead and close up that gap that we had in there. So that gives it a nice clean timeline for us. Good. All right, so let's undo that one again. This time I'm going to show you a little bit more complex way to do it. So we're going to go to the retime controls. You can do that a couple of different ways. You can hit Control R on a Windows machine, Command R on a Mac. You go right to the speed controls, or you can right click on the clip and go to retime controls here. So when you do that, you're going to get this extra bar here, and then we have this pull down. So placing a reverse clip into this sequence here, what it's going to do is based on where I have the playhead at the time I place that point in there. So I'm gonna start it this time at the very start, go to this pull down and go to rewind. And so let's do 200%. So what it does is it's got 100%, that's the full clip. It's going to go to 200 in reverse and then 100 in full speed again. So let's just go near the end of that clip. This is slow motion. So she goes in the water, comes back out, and let's go right back into jumping again. So you can change the speed by grabbing these little handlebars here, and this will change the front end speed. So if I want to select that reverse speed, it's the second one there. And or you can go to these pull downs and select a new speed under rewind again, go to 400. Okay, so like I said, it's the point of when it goes into reverse is based on where I had the playhead. So let's go ahead and go to one of these pull downs, and we're going to just reset this entire clip. And let's do this again. So if I have it, say, at this point, this is going to be our point when we reverse it. Go to the pull down, and we'll go to 800. And so she's going to go in the water. It's just going to get the splash there. And where you place that, you can't really drag and change it. You have to go in and create a new rewind or a new reverse clip option somewhere along this timeline. And so you kind of got to get the feel of that when you place those, but it's very effective, very quick to do that. And what I suggest is if you're going to make this longer by slowing it down, just move the clip after it because it's going to merge into the clip after it. Otherwise, you're going to have to do some editing after the fact and then just slide it into place where you want it after that. I was actually speeding it up, so I wasn't getting rid of this clip here. But that's the pretty simple way and a little bit more complex way to reverse a clip in DaVinci Resolve 16. Hopefully, that's helpful for you. If you have any questions on how to do that, please post them in the comments. Otherwise, thanks again for watching. Take care.